In this video, we'll see how to work on the customized result part. When I say customized result part, now when I execute this code, which I've done in the previous video for a if else condition, any condition it goes, it gives the pass result. But if I want to give my own result, let's say if it goes in this place, I want the result as pass. If it goes in this loop, it should give the result as fail. So that kind of result, if I want, I'll be using as reporter.reportEvent. That is one command which I can use. I can put that command in this if condition and it can work properly. So let us see that. Now, what I'll do is, I'll try to enter that reporter.reportEvent, that's a command given, into this place. So reporter.reportEvent, I've pressed tab. The moment I press tab here, space, it says, what do you want? Do you want the done, pass, fail, or warning? What exactly you want? So I'll say I want the result as pass. Okay. Next, after I put a space, selected the pass, it gives me the syntax of the event. Okay, syntax, what I can do with it. It says that was the event status, put a comma, and you can write the report step name. So I'll put a comma and I'll type the step name as valid data, comma. And again, it says, give me some details about this step. So if you see here, that's given as details. So what I'll do is, I'll try to enter some data here, valid due to valid number, anything, I'll just type here. So valid data due to valid number, that's it, I've typed here. So similarly, what I'll do is, if it goes in this loop, if this message box is displayed, it will give me the result. It will not be displayed as a message box, but you will get this as a result in your result window. Similarly, if I want for the fail part, I'll just copy paste that. Okay, so I'll just select that. Or better, I'll just type it again. Here I'll type as reporter.reportEvent space. And now I'll select from here as mcfail space, comma. And I'll type the step name as invalid data, comma. And again, I can type here some details about the step. So I'll say as enter, reason is invalid data. Okay, so I've typed here as reason is invalid data. So now when I execute, you can see both the results. One will be for pass and one will be fail. So purposely what I'll do is, I'll try to enter a value which is greater than, let's say less than zero. If it is less than zero, it will come directly here and you'll get the result as fail. So let's see that. I'll just click on this run button and click on this run. I've got the number. I'll just put the number as minus 90, enter. So it says that's an invalid number. So it went to the second place. I'll just click on OK. Now when I get the result window, in that result window, you can see the custom result. Okay. So I've got this in this test flow. There's a custom invalid data. Invalid data is given here. So once I click on that, on the right hand side, you can see the result. So what is the result? The run error is nothing but invalid data. And the description is given as reason is invalid data. So I've got the reason, the step name, and everything is given here. So this way you can customize your own error messages, your own messages which you want in the output. So let us see once again. I'll just execute for this positive condition. I'll just run it, click on run. Now I'll enter number which is greater than zero. Let's say I'll put as 89 and I'll click on OK. It is saying as valid number. Now it should go to this place. Click on OK. Now if you see, I've got this if else condition, that was result 6. If I click on this custom valid data, okay, on the right hand side, if you see, I've got the custom step, that was valid data, and the description is given as valid due to valid number, right? So I hope you're able to understand what are the different types of custom reports which you can give, the results which you can customize according to your requirement. I hope you have understood, and that's all for this video.